terrific shot of Nathan Phillips Square here in downtown Toronto. It's interconference time for these Thunder as they come in as the visiting team. And as we start the weekend here on this Friday night, 2K Sports welcoming you to NBA basketball. Along with Greg Anthony, Brett Berry, and our sideline reporter David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan. Look at Toronto. These guys have been getting it done pretty much everywhere in the midst of a good stretch here. Back home again could propel them to another win.
Well, it's always nice to come home. You're comfortable, you're excited, and certainly you have the fans there looking for you to bring your best basketball and get a win. And oftentimes, your fans can energize you when you're in your home building.
And with tip-off coming up, we've got just enough time to hear from our good friend David Aldridge on the sideline. D.A., take it away.
Thank you, Kevin. Now, Dwayne Casey has been the head coach in Toronto for the better part of a decade now. He said the most rewarding part of coaching has been watching his players grow up, watching a guy go from never playing in an NBA game before to developing into an all-star player. That's probably the most rewarding thing that you can do as a coach. Now, Kevin, he's helping this team and its players both make the leap forward.
Great stuff, D.A. Coach Casey definitely gets the best out of his guys. You can tell they love playing for him. Two teams tonight that love to get out and run. Brent, talk about some of the keys to being effective in the transition game.
Well, one part about transition, Kevin, is the first couple steps that anybody takes to get out on the break. I mean, there is a skill to running hard in transition and then secondarily getting wide in the lane. So many coaches are yelling at their players about creating space by getting to the sidelines as quickly as possible. Those two things can make you pretty dynamic in the open floor.
All right, let's set the floor courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. So for Oklahoma City right now, Paul George is out there with Anthony, then there's Brewer, and then there's Stephen Adams, and it's Westbrook in at the point. The three from George. Toronto grabs the miss. They defeated Indiana in their last game.
Just a terrific effort off the bench. Guys came in, they seemed fresh, and they all contributed.
Well, most of the time, guys come off the bench and just try to stabilize. Tonight, they got some serious points, and when you're on the road, it gives you unanticipated advantages.
And Kyle Lowry, over the last few seasons, slimmed down about 15 pounds. He's, Greg, been playing the best basketball of his career.
No doubt. He's still got that low center of gravity, almost like a bowling ball. He just gets under his man, and his strength and tenacity enable him to create chaos at both ends of the floor.
Two shots.
And the first one at the line is good.
And I like how scrappy and aggressive Lowry is on the court. And it's easy to see how much his teammates enjoy playing alongside him.
And so Lowry nails both of them. Well, one thing the Thunder have always done well is control the glass. Good rebounding team.
Well, the Thunder are great candidates to end up near the top for both offensive and defensive rebounds, and it certainly helps when Russell Westbrook is tearing down over 10 boards a game. It's a complete effort with this ball club, and they have guys who are willing to stick their nose in it.
And there's typically going to be some space when you're out in transition and you do just kind of venture out to that three-point line.
Now here's Anthony, turned in an outstanding game against Atlanta.
Carmelo really has great footwork down low, showing off the feel right there when he gets near the paint.
Over to the wing. Here's Ibaka. That's in, coming off an assist from Lowry. Ibaka's got his first bucket in this one.
And well-coordinated shot mechanics, especially for a guy with his length.
Yeah, he's certainly able to shoot over the top of people. High percentage look right there from the mid-range.
And if he can hit that shot, it spreads the defense out and really changes the complexion of the game.
Yeah, you can start to creep away off of certain people, but this is an early warning shot from him.
Here's Anthony. And a kind roll that time off the rim as that one falls. Anthony's got his second basket.
Well, Carmelo Anthony operating in the mid-range is just danger zone. You got to put your defense at DEFCON 1.
Goes up at the stripe. It's rebounded by Oklahoma City. Their last encounter was in Oklahoma City.
And they cruised to a big win in their last meeting, getting that opposing starting lineup out of the game early with foul trouble.
And let's see if they bring that same attacking mindset with them into this game. They should. It worked like a charm last time, getting so many guys into foul trouble.
Here is Ibaka. Steven Adams making his last shot. Just five to shoot. Here's DeRozan. And the shot is good, dropping in off the front of the rim.
Working the in-between area, the kind of look that can get you into a rhythm early.
Now, scratching my head a little bit about how the defense is trying to play this. No one there really contesting the shot.
And defensively, this is a nightmare. He's already on a roll.
I love his will, his take charge attitude, the aggressiveness, all of that showing up here in the first.
Guys, that's just really unstoppable. He poses a ton of matchup problems for whomever he's facing.
And Russell Westbrook again. Westbrook's got 7 points in the game.
More power of Westbrook shown there. Not many guys can finish through contact like that.
Westbrook against Lowry. Ibaka sets the pick for Lowry. Ibaka outside. Here's DeRozan. That one drops for him. He's got 6. And Brett, when you hear Donovan on the sideline or in the huddle, it's clear how big a motivator he can be for his team. He certainly gets the most out of his players from the stars to the end of the bench.
One thing that Billy Donovan did in the early part of taking the job with the Oklahoma City Thunder, and I remember it well, Kevin, I went to the UCLA campus where Billy Donovan had invited most of the roster for the Oklahoma City team, and he started to establish that trust in the offseason, being there for workouts, understanding the personalities of his team, and getting to know his guys. All of those things have reaped some incredible rewards in the early part of Billy Donovan's coaching career.
Here's Anthony following the score by DeMar DeRozan. Guys, we've seen some excellent offensive output.
Yeah, great momentum for them offensively.
It is now to Ibaka. Lowry passes to Valanciunas. Lays it in without an inch of room around him.
And he's pretty relentless inside. Valanciunas gets after it down low. It might not always look pretty, but he makes the most of his chances in the paint.
4-3, Westbrook. The shot's good on the assist by George. And that's now 10 points for Russell Westbrook. Here's DeRozan. He picked up 24 points in their last win against Indiana.
Felt like he had a sense in that game that the defense was being over-aggressive, and he tried to take advantage of that. He continually frustrated them throughout the night and got to the free throw line.
And so it's DeMar DeRozan making highlights for the Toronto Raptors. He notched 8 points in the quarter and has that terrific basketball instinct on display. We've got more in store for you right after this. Chance to hear from DeMar DeRozan talking about his team's impressive play of late.
We all just playing together. You know, that's the biggest thing. Moving the ball, playing together on the defensive end. You know, just having trust in one another. You know, that's the bottom line. You know, once we play comfortable, go out there and have fun, we all clicking.
And DeMar is definitely a guy, Greg, that knows how to infuse that chemistry and teamwork on the floor. It looks like he's a big reason why they're clicking.
Kevin, no doubt. And attitude, such a huge factor in being successful as an individual, but really also as a team. I think we've seen him really embrace that attitude as he's matured as a player.
And the first quarter is in the books. Second about ready to get underway. Taking a look here at the Raptors' performance here, guys. What have they been doing or not doing, in your opinion?
So far, they've been active scoring the basketball, built up a little lead here, and looking good.
Well, when you come out in the first quarter with that kind of offense, obviously the game plan is in full effect. Let's see if they can keep that momentum going.
On the floor for Oklahoma City, getting going here in the second quarter. They've got Huestis. He's out there with Patrick Patterson. Grant is out there with Felton. And it's Abrines in at the two-guard spot. And we've got an update here, so let's check in with David Aldridge reporting from the sideline.
Well, Kevin, it may not be the era of the center in the NBA, but Jonas Valanciunas has something to say about that. He said, "I try to make sure they don't forget about centers. I'll keep reminding them. The league is full of guys that can do different things, but I still think you need a center that can rebound the ball and score in the low post. I agree. Kevin?
Well, the centers are still important, David. Good to see Valanciunas making his presence felt in the paint. Nogueira with the bucket.
Yeah, that's pretty much a perfect pass, and that's also alliteration.
And in today's game, we're really so used to thinking of passing as the key to an efficient offense. But this Raptors club, they do it a different way. For them, the screen is the assist, giving their guard space to pull up or attack the rim.
Nogueira gets a screen for Miles. And stolen by Patterson. Grant against Miles. Here's Patterson, and that comes off the assist by Raymond Felton. Patterson's got 4 points this quarter. And the Raptors for the last few seasons, Greg, right at the bottom of the league in assists.
Yeah, but nevertheless, they do make good decisions. They're a low turnover team, and they've been pretty efficient offensively. One area where you can offset that is by their ability to get to the free throw line, because that puts a lot of pressure on your defense with their ability to attack.
Raptors with the lead. Feeds it to Miles. Pass to Siakam. He kicks it to Powell. Here's Siakam. He picked up 12 points in their last win against Indiana.
Well, I think he was especially impressive on the glass. The defense had no idea what to do with him. Artful passing on that play, showing the real desire to set up the teammate.
Back to Patterson for three. Siakam pulls it in.
And he didn't punish them for the weak coverage there, but they can't count on him to continue missing.
And Wright kicks to Nogueira. Back to Wright. Good ball movement here by the Raptors. Six to shoot. Nogueira gets a screen for Miles. Shoots over Patterson. Here's Siakam. And he battles for the ball and gets the second chance bucket. Now it's a 7-point Raptor lead.
How about the perseverance there, the extra effort on that offensive glass?
And first timeout of the game called for Oklahoma City. They are coming off that win against Atlanta.
They executed on the road, stayed focused, stayed consistent with who you are as a team.
Such a confidence builder to go on the road and be able to dictate the tempo, the style of play, keep your identity. They were able to do that here.
For Toronto, for the Thunder. Brent, you were known for your leaping ability. You won a dunk contest. We all remember it very vividly. During the pre-draft process, did they measure your max vertical?
They did, Kevin. At the Chicago pre-draft camp, you run through a series of tests there. Your conditioning, how your CO2 gets kicked out. They put this mask on you and check your stamina. There's a bunch of doctors in there poking and prodding. I won't go into detail about that.
Thank you.
But they did measure the max vertical during that Chicago pre-draft, and it was about a 39-inch vertical leap, so not too bad.
Not too bad at all. Here's Westbrook. That's in. That's his fifth field goal. He's shooting a hot 71%, 5-for-7. Screened by Ibaka. Van Vliet passes to Ibaka. Oh, and a fast break for Oklahoma City.
Yeah, how about the sharp steal and then run out? It looks like they're ready to put the hammer down.
Well, we've been waiting for one of these teams, Greg, to pull away. Maybe that'll be a springboard for them.
Well, this team now has to settle in right here and have a great possession without getting so aggressive that you compound your mistake.
Pass to Purdy. Back to Ibaka. Over Anthony. Ibaka, no luck. Thunder trailing by three. Westbrook dishes to Adams. Chalk up two there.
Well, that's something Adams is working on right there. Finishing plays strong with a hand in his face.
And DeRozan kicks to Ibaka. There's the pick. Back to DeRozan. The Ibaka sets the pick for DeRozan. Six on the shot clock. Anunoby, good. Anunoby has got five now.
And they keep hammering away at him inside, forcing the ball into the paint.
The three from George. And that comes off the assist by Russell Westbrook. Westbrook's got four assists in the game. And so it's tied as we head to halftime. And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Kevin, thanks. Billy, balanced scoring for your team. How pleased are you with the way they're keeping everybody involved offensively?
Well, those guys, I think, have done a really good job of moving the ball and sharing the ball, and they're finding open men and they're willing passers. And I think because of that, they've been efficient offensively.
Open shots tend to be made. Thanks, Coach. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, Dave, thank you. And time now for the halftime break with the third quarter soon to follow right here on 2K Sports.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
And we hope you enjoyed the competitive first half of action. Ernie Johnson here welcoming you back to the 2K Sports Halftime Show. That guy right there is Shaquille O'Neal, and that guy right there is Kenny the Jet Smith. DeMar DeRozan brought his A game early tonight. He had 8 points, 3 assists, and 1 rebound. And taking a look at the Raptors, Kenny, what did you see out there?
So far, I love their commitment on the glass. Even when they were playing well, their rebounding remained a priority. And so far, the other side hasn't matched their efforts.
And now, Shaq, let's get your opinion on Oklahoma City.
I really like how they limited turnovers. You know, they didn't play it too safe. They made some really nice passes. When you can play like this and cut back turnovers, it can add up to over 10, 8, 12, 15, 16 easy points, Ernie. I don't know how many points, a lot of easy points. They'll be in good shape if they can keep making the same smart plays.
And we're just about ready for the start of the third quarter. Kevin Harlan standing by. We'll see you.
Welcome back to Toronto, where the gigantic CN Tower dominates the skyline. The third quarter now beginning. Both sides looking to pull away in the last half of the game. Well, you look at Russell Westbrook in this game, he has been everywhere.
And in that first half, something we don't see a lot of from him, the ability to make everyone around him better.
No, that's not really his forte, Greg. Unselfish play.
Lowry with the ball. Ibaka is the four, and Valanciunas in the middle. The talented Lowry and DeRozan pair in the backcourt. And it's Anunoby in at the small forward position. So that's the five in the game for Toronto.
And defensively, this is the opposite of how you want to start the second half.
Yeah, it's like four teenagers at home over the summer, just not enough activity. You've gotten your rest. It's time to man up.
So they take the lead. 15 points for Russell Westbrook.
Yeah, that's two straight three-pointers they've allowed.
And when you watch Russell Westbrook play, he's one of the most competitive players in the NBA.
And with the way he attacks the rim and plays with just no abandon, I mean, this guy is no joke. Absolutely wills himself and his team to just do things that few others can, and relentless from the first quarter to the last whistle.
And George gets the Bruins. Adams sets the pick for George. Buries it down low. George has got five now. Toronto's gone 4-6 from outside the arc tonight. Oh, the lob to DeRozan. Brewer with the steal. Three-pointer. He doesn't hit that one. And it's the Raptors taking it the other way. Following this one, they get to host the Mavericks. And that will be the middle game of this three-game homestand. Valanciunas. So the whistle blows on the shot, and two free throws for the contact right there.
Really, the right play defensively. If you can't block, force them to the line.
And Valanciunas out of Lithuania, the fifth overall pick back in 2011.
Yeah, he's still quite young. You know, a lot of talent offensively. Defensively, he's probably had less of an impact, but that's where he has to take the next step. Two shots. Last
of the first.
First free throw is good.
And the Raptors, unique in the NBA, they have a whole nation behind them.
And basketball continues to gain in popularity, especially with the younger generation in Canada. The Raptors are coming to relevance at the perfect time, and that rabid fan base energized by how competitive this group's been the last couple seasons.
Hey, Brent, looking at the mental aspect of the game, we usually think about crafty veterans, but who are some of the craftiest young players that you see right now?
That's a good question, Kevin. I might have a few surprise answers for you. How about Tyler Johnson, maybe? Malcolm Brogdon in Milwaukee last year, who showed some things as an older rookie playing 4 years in college at Virginia. Chris Dunn, he's got a bit of trickery to him. And the last guy I'll throw out there is Joe Ingles. Has a little spice to his game when he's got the basketball in Utah.
Lowry kicks to Miles. Valanciunas sets a screen for Miles. He feeds it to Valanciunas. Lays it up and banks it in. Valanciunas has got 4 points in the quarter.
And they're forcing the ball inside, and it's working like a charm.
And stolen by Kyle Lowry. Here's Powell. He goes up again. No good from Valanciunas.
Yeah, just misjudged the layup. Defense has to be better. Very fortunate there.
It's stolen by Lowry. Last break. Here come the Raptors. Takes the assist and lays it in. Picked out the pass nicely. Powell's got 9.
Textbook bounce pass there. Perfectly timed.
Okay, well, let's check in with David Aldridge, who's reporting from the sideline.
Guys, Raptors coach Dwayne Casey talked about the chemistry on his team. He said, we couldn't be better. There's no ego, no hidden agendas. Guys understand their roles. Kyle Lowry told me, we're a complete team, 15 deep, and we really mean that. You never know whose time it's going to be. Kevin?
D.A. depth is a crucial part of any team's success. When you can rely on your teammates to step up is huge. Now a timeout called by Oklahoma City.
Yeah, it's a good time to talk things over. Try to stop what's been a brutal run.
Yeah, he's got to use every device at his disposal at this point. And I think he wants to give other guys a breather right now.
Checked in for Jonas Valanciunas. Ferguson's checked in for Oklahoma City. Felton comes in for Alex Abrines. Felton kicks to Westbrook. That's good, and so Felton has the assist there. Westbrook's got 6 points in the quarter.
You know, just an incredibly difficult cover. Westbrook with the dexterity to come off the screen in great position.
Passes it to Lowry. And again, Toronto with the triple.
Timely passing leads to assists, and that's been the recipe for success.
A minute 20 left to play in the third. In the corner, it's Westbrook, and the Thunder another three.
I don't know, I'm getting the feeling as this game moves on, he's getting stronger.
Lowry kicks to Poeltl. He dishes it to Miles, and the call is going to be, yes, it is, an illegal screen. This is the 2K leaderboard with a rundown of the NBA's top defenders down low, the league's leaders in rejections this month, and number 5, Jakob Poeltl.
And guys, as the month has unfolded, his interior defense has gotten better and better.
Adams, he's checked in for Oklahoma City. Anthony comes in for Eustace. And again, Oklahoma City, no good.
If they play it right, we're talking a 2-for-1.
Yeah, this is where it comes down to really good clock management, and you want to maximize each of your possessions.
Felton kicks to Westbrook. Down it drops through the net for his 9th bucket. He is 9-for-13 so far.
Great quarter for him at the offensive end, trying to will his team back in the game.
The putback, great positioning on the putback.
And really credit their advantage on the backboard. That's where the lead has been built, and that's why they are in control.
And there's the pass to Ferguson. Dishes it to Anthony. Over Nogueira. Nice spin off the left rim and in. 8 points for Carmelo Anthony.
Yeah, not a good idea to leave him alone. He'll make you pay for that mid-range.
And so it's the Toronto Raptors with a 6-point lead at the end of the quarter. They're shooting the ball so well in this one, a great performance from the field. Right back after this break. Let's take a listen to a recent huddle from Coach Billy Donovan.
We got a chance to get a great road win right now. We got to battle and fight and get down and dirty right now. Right? Let's go. Energy's got.
Words moments ago from Billy Donovan, feeling they have a good chance to take one here on the road, asking for more hustle.
Yeah, it's enough that you're going up against a team on their turf in front of such a hostile crowd. You have to give maximum effort.
And we're set to start the action up here in the fourth quarter. And if it's anything like the first three, we should be in for a treat. And Oklahoma City, looking who they've got to start the fourth quarter. Russell Westbrook out there with Brewer. And then there's Steven Adams. Then it's Anthony. And it's George in at the three. And DeRozan kicks to Van Vliet. Toronto working the ball around now. Beyond the clock. A three ball. Good. And it's DeRozan picking up the assist. DeRozan's got 4 assists now tonight.
And defensively, neither side able to get many stops.
Well, it's one of those nights where if a team down the stretch can get 1 or 2 stops, they may win it.
Yeah, the onslaught continues. He's been unstoppable now for a couple of nights.
Well, a tip of the cap to the coaching staff here. They're recognizing how well he's playing, so the game plan has been built around him. He didn't need to fade back. No one in his face, but he buried it anyway.
Now, here's George. Out to Anthony. From about 19 feet. And it's Toronto with the rebound. They've led by as many as 11 points. Pass to Van Vliet. Here's Ananobi. There's a good screen. Shot off the pick. That one, no good. Excellent D there from George. Kicks it to Westbrook. That shot off. And it's the Raptors taking it the other way. Stolen by Westbrook. And it's out of bounds. The Raptors will take it the other way. Raptors leading by 7. To the wing right side. Here's Ananobi. Rebound by Anthony.
It looked like he wanted no part of that. Superb defense there. Really making it tough on him.
Took him no time at all on that one.
Melo good at scanning the entire floor, and that's why that time he found the open teammate.
Valanciunas with a screen on Westbrook. And Wright kicks to Ibaka. Here's Ananobi, screened by Ibaka. DeRozan, that's good. And the Raptors lead by 7.
And certainly, they are not hesitating, letting it fly from deep here in the second half.
And here's George for 3. And that comes off the assist by Russell Westbrook. 10 points for George.
The awareness of Russell Westbrook to locate the open man and deliver a strike. Something he's developing.
Really the best result they could have hoped for on that possession. They get back all 3 points they just gave up and are close to putting this thing out of reach.
Here's Anthony. And DeMar DeRozan pulls it down.
Not a lot of defense there. You can't afford to let guys shoot freely from the mid-range. They're not going to miss those all that often. Well, passing is something he does very well, especially when it comes to leading his man to the right spot.
Here's Westbrook. Again, the Thunder score.
Well, he's got no problem getting to that spot on the floor. Westbrook now looks more confident in those kind of results.
Right, the pass to Ananobi. And there's the feed to DeRozan. Over Brewer. And there are the Raptors with another bucket.
And every move he makes looks like the right one at this point.
Yeah, shooting at a very high percentage right now. This one extending the lead.
Again, the miss by Anthony. They can take their time on this possession.
Yeah, it wouldn't be a bad idea just give themselves a little bit of a break.
Now the dish to Valanciunas. And Adams sends it back.
Adams is a decent shot blocker, but relies on his position mostly, that time in the right spot.
Anthony in a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot two here.
Gentlemen, two shots. Move shots.
He drops the first one, and that brings them within eight.
Just get a feeling like Melo has brought some extra energy to this one. This guy eats, drinks, and breathes basketball, but he's at it here tonight.
Kyle Lowry, he's checked in for the Raptors. Both free throws good from Anthony. Toronto's gotten off to a great start from three-point range in the final quarter. They're a perfect 3 of 3. And DeRozan kicks to Valanciunas. Feeds to Lowry. And the Raptors hit again from deep.
And you can tell they're ready to start celebrating a well-deserved victory here tonight.
Yeah, you can see the fans. They've already started celebrating themselves. A gutty performance.
Now a timeout called by Oklahoma City. They're trailing by 10. 43 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Chance to present our Jordan player of the game, DeMar DeRozan.
Yeah, and his percentage from the field tonight seemed almost made up. I didn't think it was possible to have that kind of success shooting the basketball. You need a little bit of luck, a bunch of hard work, and a whole lot of talent.
What a connection he has to these fans. They love him here. And the more he has games like this, the deeper that connection gets. City going with a whole new group out there. Felton inside the three-point line, and it's good. He planted his feet on the pick and shielded the defender off.
Oh, nice screen. Really a poor defensive reaction and the obvious result.
Yeah, when you fail to get over the top, more than likely that jumper is going to go down.
Running up the score, showing no mercy.
Well, you want to close the door on any type of comeback effort. This has been a vault. Ka-ching.
You're right.
Well, you got to like his choice right there to go hard to the rack. Took it right at the teeth of the defense.
Here's Van Vliet. He's covered by Felton. Here's Van Vliet. So it's Toronto winning this one. Even early on in this one, it seemed like they were happy to be playing at home tonight.
And it makes a big difference. Once they started to really play in rhythm, you never felt like they had any doubts as to whether or not they were going to win.
And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Kevin, thank you. DeMar, this team is playing well together. How are you encouraging and fostering that sense of all of you being together and playing well?
We're just making everybody comfortable. We're making each and everybody on this team comfortable. If it's jump shots, if it's attacking the basket, you know, even if it's on the defensive end. You know, we're just giving each other confidence every time we practice.
And it sure looks like it out there tonight, DeMar. Thanks a lot. Kevin, back to you.
All right, David. Great job. Thanks so much. And that'll do it, folks. For Brent Berry, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.